Greetings and texting at the heart of our human experience is a shared language. It's the way that we order our universe and the way that we express our hopes and fears. Fears like, I don't know, maybe machines will automate us so much that one day they'll just take us over and become our overlords. But why do some ideas die on the vine while others grow along it until they reach the recesses of our minds and they're encoded into clusters of neurons that survive into long-term memory? To answer that, we should consider universal Darwinism, this idea that you have an algorithm, you have variation, you have selection, you have heredity or replication, and then you have evolution or natural design. In a similar way, evolutionary biologist Richard Dawkins suggests that it's information, it's words, it's instructions of a gene that moves life forward. Our genes are essentially selfish, and they have to be because their only responsibility is to replicate and to be selected for. So in the same way, the ideas we circulate are behaving like genes in an organism. You have language in communication, which is information copied with variation and selection. It's a little like the telephone game. A meme is a self-perpetuating idea. Essentially, it's viral. It's the reason why when I say sneezing panda or overly attached girlfriend, clusters of neurons will serve up all sorts of images and ideas. Memeticist Susan Blackmore took this idea a step further, and she said that not only are we meme machines and gene machines trying to forward our DNA and our ideas, but now we are also team machines. By team, Blackmore means that we are perpetuating technology and that we are the hosts that technology is riding on until it can have variation, selection, and copying all outside of humans. Think about it. To some degree, technology is already self-replicating, and it doesn't care about the planet, and it doesn't care about us. And like a computer virus or a biological virus, its only aim is perpetuation. And if you doubt, consider computer brain interfaces or Google glasses or RFID chips that we implant under our skin so that we can scan our own personal information, information we put therefore technology. As we continue to merge with technology, the team machine becomes stronger, more robust, its tentacles reaching out into every aspect of the world, just like technology planned it. I kid. The singularity, the point that machine takes over man, isn't nigh. Or is it? Let us know in the comments below. And to keep the videos coming, make sure to subscribe.